Okay, then coming to NPCB, which is Neelakasham. Neelakasham Pachakadal Juvana Bhumi. I'm so happy that it has a small NPCB thing. Yeah, blue skies, green ocean, and red earth. Yeah, I know the translation. Watch NPCB director film Chappa Kurishu, starring Fahad. Okay, the title means, yes, I know the title means. It's an emotion. You guys may not like my thoughts on the film now with all those comments. So I watched it on Discord yesterday. It was yesterday, guys. Mods, it was yesterday or day before yesterday? On Friday. Friday night we watched it. And it's a road movie. A very good attempt. Non-linear storytelling. We were talking about the movie later, and someone was like, he didn't like the non-linearity. But I was okay with it. I think it made it more fun. Okay, road movie. Good attempt, non-linear. Yes, good camera work. Very good visuals. Disappointing for us because we watched it on. It's both on Amazon and Hotstar, but on Amazon, no subtitles. And on Hotstar, the quality is not that good. So, Hotstar is just disappointing, man. See, now in the plot, I felt like they went a little far-fetched with some of the things. Like, too many things happened in the plot, like the events that take place in one's life. It was just too unrealistic at a moment that he went through all of this. And just too many things, too many coincidences. And I think the last thing I was expecting in a road film was a family drama. That there's a love story and the family not accepting the girl and all of that. Like, that's the last thing I would expect from a road film. And okay. Then, I was expecting an isolated journey kind of thing when I knew it's a road movie. It's about love and exploration and philosophies. I thought it'll be more, we'll be the character exploring things, something like that. But it was very different. It does subvert my expectations. I think it came out 2013, and for that time, people say it's a really good film. I will agree to that if people say that. And again, it does subvert expectations because you think something has happened, now it become a thriller, that there's a killer and there's this and there's that, but they subvert expectations. No, it's not about that. It's about moving on. It's about learning from things. So I like that aspect of the film. DQ was good. The actor played who played Sunni was good. I think Sunni was very desperate, and we were laughing at some of the things he was doing in the film. He was too desperate, and again, he was very stereotypical friend. He'll do anything. He's just there. He's just DQ's friend. That's his characteristics. Nothing else. I think that was one of a weak thing in the film. Again, I think I've heard this film is so close to people. I think this film started the trend of Bullet. People love getting Bullet and going on a vacation or a trip. So I understand that, and it's a big thing in Punjab. But yeah, Bullet is fun. I understand that. My brother is a big fan. He wants me to come with him, but I don't know. Yeah, movie had too many issues for me. Just okay for me when I'm thinking about now. Yeah, maybe for that time it's good. I like the road scenes and all. It was well made, but the main story was meh. Bullet trend actually started from 90s Mohanlal movies. I'm sorry. I was told that this film started it. Sorry. Yep. Yes. Same film. NPCB has a cult following. I know. Dude, Sunny is read Sunny like real Sunny and not Sunny. Dude, Sunny is read Sunny like real Sunny. Okay, Sunny. Sorry. Thank you for correction. People love it because of his bullet and riding thing. Unfortunately, this is the only that kind of a movie in India. I think Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara is very different than this. Songs in NPCB by Rex Vaidyanathan was so trending then. Okay, songs were good. Song I talked about songs, right? Music was good.